I'm out riding today to do a Q&A video because every once in a while somebody will ask a question and I have a huge answer and I don't want to create a wall of text. Hello kitty, just cross the road, don't get hit. The question I got was, why do I ride a scooter? And the second question is, do I feel it's unsafe? Like, don't I feel it's unsafe that I can't keep up with the cars all the time, especially on the bigger roads? I ride a scooter because it's all I can afford. And I saved up a lot of birthday money, like all my birthday money. I actually never spent any of it from Easter, birthday, anything that I've ever gotten from when I was little. I never spent any of it. I just saved it up. I used it to buy a 50cc scooter, but I didn't have my driver's license yet or anything, so I couldn't really ride it. And then I was convinced to get a 150cc because the 50s are pretty slow, and I guess I agreed to it, and so my parents paid off the difference. It was only like $100 more. I'm not really sure if this bike was used or new, or it only had 8 miles on the odometer, but... So, why a scooter? Like, why? Why didn't I get a motorcycle? Well, of course, I said I could only afford a scooter, but it seems like you could find pretty good motorcycles for a good price, too, but I really didn't know anything about anything, and my friend had a scooter, and it's the first time I ever saw a scooter. They really weren't a thing yet, at least around here. See, here's a scooter right now. So my friend had a scooter and rode it to my house, not my house, but, and I was like, oh, look at that, that's pretty cool. Anyway, that's what wanted me to get a scooter, is because my friend had one. That's pretty much it. Had I known that I could get a used motorcycle for around the same price, I don't know if I would have got one or not, rather than getting a scooter. But either way, the turn of events ended up to me getting a scooter, and so that's just what I've had, and it's what I ended up with. I've been happy with it, except when it breaks down, but it's really usually not anything too big of a deal. It's usually just the CDI comes unplugged or something. I've been really lucky because I haven't been taking care of my bike that well. At least in the first few years, I really was bad to it. Now, the second question was about top speed. Like, do I feel it's unsafe since I can't go as fast as other cars? Usually the roads I'm on, I can usually go as fast as the cars, at least. There's a lot of times I could pass them, but I don't like to, like, wind out my engine, so I don't go faster than them because of that. But I can go faster than if I want, like, to pass a car or something. Yeah, I have a little more room to go quicker there. The top speed on my scooter I've ever gotten was 60, indicated on my thing. I think it was more like actually 55 or 53, because I think my speedometer is a little bit low. Or it's a little bit high, it indicates higher than what it is. So basically on roads that are 40 miles per hour, my bike handles it no problem. It could do it all day. Roads that are 50, not so much. Roads that are 55, forget it. Like, I mean, I could do it, but I might as well just let everyone pass me. I don't want to wind my engine up to near red line all the whole street, you know? So overall, yes, I would love more top speed, which is something I'm working on right now. I discovered my belt is actually pretty worn out. I mean, it's 5, 6 years old now. And it's lost 2 millimeters out of its width. So, and apparently when that happens to your belt, you lose top speed. So I've got a new belt on the way. I've got some tools that I need to get it all off and all that stuff, so looking forward to that. And if the belt doesn't make enough of a difference, I'm going to change out my rollers to heavier rollers, which should help a lot with the revving. When I have a passenger on my bike, top speed isn't really an issue, but acceleration gets it gets hard to accelerate, like, because you have extra weight on it, and this is a pretty light bike. I think it's only 220 pounds, so it's a pretty light bike, and adding, like, any weight, you could feel it. Like, I'm pretty sure when I used to be underweight a couple years ago, my bike was a lot quicker. I've gained, like, 30 pounds since then. I'm not ashamed to talk about that. There's not a huge difference now that I gained some weight, but I think it probably was a little snappier with the acceleration before. Now, on a 50cc, there's absolutely no way I could handle a 50cc on the road. No way. Maybe on a side road, but not a road like this. As soon as I get some green lights, I'll show you, like, that I have enough power to pass people on a street like this, 35, 40 speed limit. Okay, well, I'm doing it now, apparently. Okay, here we go. Well, this is only 35 here, but I'm going about 45 right now. No, I'm probably only going 40, honestly, because my speedometer. But see, I'm passing people. It's not really an issue. But yeah, the bigger roads are a problem because people usually go over the speed limit, at least 5, 10 over the speed limit. And so if it says 50, they're probably going 55, 60. And I that's when I can't keep up. And that's when, yeah, I do feel it's dangerous on a road like that. Because people start passing me, people start in their pickup trucks, they start flipping me off. And see, like right now, we're just kind of cruising at 43, which is probably 40, but my engine's like, and so so when I get this new belt and maybe heavier rollers, that RPM's gonna probably be closer to like 5,000, 5,200 or something. And my bike's gonna just love cruising at this speed, because right now I've only got the throttle at like 20%. I could give it more. Here, I'll give it more for you. This is all the way. This is all the way. Actually, I'm not really going that fast. Sometimes it wants to go 60, sometimes it just can't get past 50, 55. Indicated 55. So that concludes my first Q&A video. If you have any questions you want to ask, feel free to leave them in a comment on this video, and I will respond to your question to tell you whether I'm going to include it in my next video, my next Q&A video. And then just stay tuned, and your question shall be answered in the next Q&A video. I don't know what that accent was for, but okay. We'll see you in the next video.